My name is Ruud van den Bos. I'm a freelance lecturer, researcher and consultant in the field of neurobiology and experimental psychology. And I work here as guest researcher at the Radboud University at the Department of Animal Ecology and Physiology. We have emotional systems, such as related to anxiety or reward, and normally they help us navigate through life. But sometimes they get out of hand. We lose control over these systems. Now, I've done studies in humans to understand that, in rodents, in cats. But zebrafish offer a new opportunity because they are the foundations of the way how vertebrates further developed. So they have a different brain than ours, but the fundamental properties are there. So my interest is trying to understand how those systems operate in zebrafish. Although their brain looks different from ours, but are these actually the same systems? But then at a mini scale, or are they lacking things that we don't have or that we have? One of the things that we've been interested in is the difference between two often used strains. The AB on the one hand, with short fins and stripes, and the tube for long fin with long fins and spots. Those spots and long fins are caused by two mutations, which are spontaneous mutations. So we were interested in what are the effects of these mutations on the behavior and physiology and gene expression in the tube for long fin. So we used DanioVision and EthoVision to understand adult behavior and larval behavior. And we have seen that these mutations are not cosmetic mutations. They also have effects on their behavior. And that means that if you have tests in two different strains, that the outcome might be different. I definitely would recommend Noldus tools to others for a number of reasons. One of them, because I think the tools are perfectly for use for many different purposes. And second, what I really like is that the contact with the people working in all this is very good. And that is, to me, very important as a researcher. If something is going on, I can make a phone call and then we can have a conversation on how to improve on the things that we're doing. One ambition that I have for the coming year is to set up or actually move towards a lab where we can integrate teaching and research here at the university, so that we can be of interest for third parties, but that we also have a true grip on our own strains and the conditions under which we have our animals. Because that will mean that we will have full control of what we're doing. I think a challenge for the future will be is whether zebrafish will really make a difference in research. Because now we have many different strains which are being reared in many different conditions and kept under many different conditions in the lab, which means that the results might not always be reproducible. Whereas at the end of the day, that's what we want to have. We want to be sure that the compound will lead to a specific result, and that we can predict what the kind of result will be. So that will be definitely, I think, a challenge for the future.